find a way to speak up when I call. Let me hear your voices. Where will your friends see you? I'm a waste of time. Do you get burnt out on your own? Maybe it's coming down the back inside. Do you get inside where to go? It's hard to watch you from the room, to watch you from the wall. It's all I got to think about. It's hard to watch you from the room, to watch you from the wall. Now, when we take this out, I need to see everybody moving. What's up?
Can't from the floor. And I left you there, spent so many days alone. So I killed myself, made things fair. I'd just say to be in time, cause I can't see sleep anymore. Even all your friends were all right about me, all alone. Just won't wait. Get you sick and tired of this smile that I fake every day. And I would love to speak my mind, but I can't think straight. I would love to feel alive again, but I'm not. We'll be right back.
How's everybody doing? Ten years ago, when we were writing Youth, we didn't have any goals or any plans or any expectations for this band. We were just kids and we were doing music because we love it. And when we were recording Youth, we were... We were renting a house in Norristown, Pennsylvania, and me and Nick Ham over there shared a bedroom, and we shared a bed, and we slept next to each other every single night. And back then, I was going through a lot of life, big life changes, or I thought they were big at the time, at least. And I was having a hard time dealing with it. And I remember one night when me and Nick were laying there trying to go to sleep, I said to him, maybe it's not a bad thing that things aren't so good right now, because we might make something pretty cool out of it. And he said, he said, yeah, I guess so. And to this day, when I see the album art or hear any of those songs, I think of that conversation, because I think that we were right. And it took me up until this year to realize that, you know, seeing everybody share their stories and say so many nice things. And I wish that me back then could have seen that now, because that would have made me happy. And I never would have thought I'd be standing here, we'd be standing here, looking at all these people, and I never thought so many people would hold this record so close, so close to their hearts. And I don't know what else to say besides we love everybody in this room, and here's to 10 years of Youth. We're forever grateful for all of you. Thank you so much.
How far I've got, I shared some secrets that I hope you keep in the words that don't come out. And I shouldn't crash the car the night I drove alone, escaped from my gas car. Talk like someone else. Been away from you, and now something's killing me. You hang me up
ghost, and I'm wondering how you're making out. Sing it with me.
You got a place to How's everybody feeling? Good. It's hard to come up with much to say that isn't just echoing everything that Matt said, but I can't tell you how grateful we are for everybody in this room right now. Time goes on and things get recontextualized, and you forget that when this album came out, this is not what citizen shows looked like. We were opening tours and we were playing for very small amounts of people, and it didn't feel at the time that the album really connected with people in mass. And like Matt said, it's kind of, time has gone on, and then we've reached this year and we've realized how much it means to a lot of people and how much that means to us. So thank you to everybody in this room right now. I can't say it enough. I also want to give a shout out to Sanguisugabog and Fiddlehead for joining us on the stage tonight. When this tour became an inkling of an idea, we talked about, you know, who should join us on these shows, and we wanted to have as many friends as possible. And one thing I know about Citizen fans is that they're open-minded and they trust the people that we have on the stage with us. And I have to say, it's really cool to watch every night how everybody reacts to these bands. And having you guys go off for Sanguisugabog and Fiddlehead is just amazing. I can't say it enough. It's so cool. I feel like we have the best fans in the world. I don't want to talk too much, but I want to give a shout out to our manager, Avange, who is up there tonight. Who's She's been with us for 11 years now. She's been here every step of the way in the trenches and beyond. And we often make her life miserable. And I don't know, I think that we were just meant to make each other miserable for the rest of time. So I know she's crying right now. I can guarantee it. Anyway, we love you, Avange. And we love you, Chicago. I can't say it enough. I love Chicago.
Push, I'm quick to shove, and I'm the first to point the fingers. even sleep, I cut to the ties, and I lose myself in my head. I convince myself, forget what it's mean. And I'll stay outside tonight, and I'll stay outside. I can't talk. I can't talk.
slow but suddenly, the things that make you happy, they are enough for me, for me, for me, for me.
flickering thoughts all wrong. Till the machine will call to stare at a glitch or fall. Sing it loud. Sing it louder.
One more time, please make some noise for Sanguisugabog and Fiddlehead. Please make some noise for yourselves for being here tonight, sharing this night with us. Ten years down the line, we're still going strong. We've got two more. This is a new one. It's called If You're Lonely.
Because we love first. Oh, I-
razor sharp and never let it show. It's like you mean me enough to never, to never, to never let me go. Do you want anything? Why look you straight into the eyes and say, this is the last time I'll ever be with you.